Frank von Giga auf dem MWC 2023, mal mit einem etwas anderen Video. Neben mir sitzt einer der Tech-CEOs von einem der interessantesten Unternehmen vielleicht derzeit, nämlich von Nothing. Das hier ist Carl Pei. Der hat im Jahr 2013 zusammen mit Pete Lau OnePlus gegründet. Jetzt macht er seit etwas über 2 Jahren was Neues, was Eigenes, nämlich Nothing. Und Nothing baut Telefone, die transparent sind, die hinten so leuchtende Glyphen haben. Und dazu möchte ich ihm jetzt mal ein paar Fragen stellen. Nach dem Intro geht's los. Carl, thank you for being with us today. My first question is a rather obvious one. Mm-hmm. What can we expect from Nothing in 2023? I mean, the Nothing Phone 2 is no secret anymore, but what can we expect in terms of like performance and software and stuff like that?
I think this year for us is going to be all about maturity. Mm-hmm. This is our third year. The first year, you know, we had to prove ourselves with the year one to get the resources we needed to deliver the Phone 1. But when we were delivering the Phone 1, we were actually building the team while also building the company. So at the beginning of the Phone 1 engineering project and at the end, the team size had increased a lot. But yeah, as the engineers were joining, you know, it takes them a few months to get into the groove of building products. And recently, we also built our own software team.
Yeah.
So for the Phone 1, a lot of the software was outsourced. But recently, when we updated it to Android 13, yeah, that was the first time it was made internally. So I would say from an engineering perspective, we're in a lot more stable place.
Yeah.
The team has already worked together, they delivered products both on the hardware side and software side.
It's the old Oxygen OS team, isn't it?
Yeah. It's a great team.
I know.
So I think the products we're seeing this year will be a lot more mature coming from us. And now that we have stronger engineering capabilities, we're also more confident in doing more innovative things. Whereas before, for instance, on the software, we had to focus just on the basics, mm-hmm, battery life, system stability, how smooth everything is. But now we can start delivering some of our own ideas into software as well.
Which ideas, for example?
I think for one, you know, when we came to the market, we brought a very fresh take on product design. Mm-hmm. We had to limit that design to just hardware. Mm-hmm. This year, we'll be able to do a lot more on the software side. Not everything we want to do, but we'll be able to take a big step from the past.
Okay, amazing. And the next phone that you will release will be much more performant, I heard.
Yeah. Yesterday, we just announced that it's going to run the Snapdragon 8 series, mm-hmm, from Qualcomm. We heard a lot of feedback from our community that they wanted to see a higher performing device, and really looking forward to their reaction.
Okay, so in another interview you told that you want to focus on the US market in 2023. What about Europe? Do you hate us or what's up with that?
I don't hate Europe, but I think Europe is a market where we need to grow in a stable way. Mm-hmm. If you look at two of the biggest markets in Europe, UK and Germany. Actually, Germany is bigger for us than UK at the mm-hmm moment. It's markets that are, you need time to build your brand.
Yeah.
Especially in the UK, people there, they care a lot about the brand. I think in Germany, it's brand, but also trust.
Yeah.
Are these guys reliable? Can I trust them? So the market is not gonna turn overnight. So we need to be patient in Europe. We will keep investing, but I don't think it's the market where we're gonna see very, very quick adoption of our products.
Okay, so your products are a bit different than other manufacturers' products. They are like designy, flashy, with those glyphs. Why is that? What value does this bring?
Well, me, but also a lot of our team were quite bored,
yeah,
by how the industry was going. Products were becoming more and more similar. Consumers were becoming more and more they paid less attention to these kind of products. And we talked to consumers, we talked to partners, and the feeling was very similar across the board. So we said, hey, look, this is something really difficult because we're starting a company like this with such a big ambition from 0 to 1, it's going to be very difficult. But looking around us, there's only big companies. And as a big company, you can't really take too many risks because you're going to risk your market position. And in other industries, there are both big companies and challengers, but not in ours. There's no challenger apart from us because it's just too hard.
Okay.
So we said, hey, look, if we don't try and do something, probably nobody else is going to do that. So let's try this and let's try and make technology more fun again.
Okay. But to break it down, it's your approach is make things transparent and flashy with those glyph lights. So, but how will your product designs evolve in the future?
I think that's a valid feedback, and it has to do with kind of developing the company in a step-by-step way. Mm-hmm. When it came to our software capabilities, as an example, really had to focus on the stability. Mm-hmm. That's like the basic experience that we really need to nail first. We had a lot of ideas, and we still do, on the future roadmap of the glyph interface, but that requires a lot of software engineering.
Okay.
So over time, we need to make it more useful. Mm-hmm. And technology can't just be about flashing lights. Technology needs to enable humans to live better somehow, or else it's not real innovation. So that's very clear for us. It's just that we need to take a step-by-step approach to that.
Okay, next question. Sustainability is basically a buzzword with people all around the world, but especially in Germany. So you recently said in an interview that you don't want to put out device after device, but you want some healthy product life cycle. So what's your general stance in terms of longevity and sustainability with your products?
I think sustainability, it is a buzzword, but it's also not, because it's actually quite important. And it's something that we started looking at more than 2 years ago when we started the company. So every week we have a weekly meeting to discuss sustainability. How can we make our products more sustainable? And it's a learning process, and our thoughts have evolved over time. You know, for the ear one, we tried to work with the factory to get them to use green energy.
Okay.
And we bought the green energy certificates for them. Mm-hmm. And then with the remaining carbon footprint, we just bought the credits to offset the carbon.
Okay.
So it was a carbon neutral product.
Ah,
but,
cool.
But then as our thinking evolved, that's kind of the easy way out. Don't do anything special on the engineering, but just pay and then your problem goes away. So we stopped that. Okay. For the phone one, we wanted to focus more on the real stuff, like supply chain, like the product R&D. So we made some initial steps with the phone one. As an example, the aluminum mid-frame is from, it's 100% recycled. Mm-hmm. And more than half of the plastics are from recycled sources as well. I think this year, in our third year, is when we can really start doing very interesting things. And we can really start communicating more with the world around our thoughts around sustainability. Because there's also this kind of greenwashing thing. Yeah. We didn't want to be that kind of company. We just go and say a lot and then do a little. We want to do a lot and then maybe say a little. And this year it's time to say a little.
Okay, great. Okay, one last question. It's a bit of a jokey one. if nothing ever made a car, would it be completely transparent? And if it was, would everybody see myself wearing sweatpants when I'm driving around?
Actually, you know, the capabilities you need to make an electric vehicle, mm-hmm. and the capabilities you need to make a smartphone, they're becoming more and more similar. The supply chain is becoming similar. Like Qualcomm, they also make stuff for the car. The factories that make smartphones are also making cars.
Yeah.
So, you know, in 10 years' time, that might not be an impossibility. But I don't think in 10 years' time we would make a fully transparent phone, a fully transparent car.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, thank you, Carl, for your time. It was a pleasure.
Thanks for having me.
See you around.
See you around.
There you have it. Also der Carl Pay ist schon einer von den cooleren Dudes unter den Tech-CEOs. Falls euch das Video gefallen hat, gebt uns gerne ein Like. Guckt auch auf dem Nothing-YouTube-Kanal mal vorbei. Da reviewed Carl unter anderem die Geräte von Konkurrenten wie OnePlus und Apple. Und bleibt uns gewogen, gebt gerne ein Like, abonniert unseren Kanal. Wir sehen uns beim nächsten Video. Ciao!